Turkey tail mushrooms, Trametes versicolor, has been used for hundreds of years in traditional medicine for its potential medicinal uses. In this video, I'm going to give you a brief history of the turkey tail mushroom, along with its potential health benefits and how you can use them too. Turkey tail mushroom, Trametes versicolor, is a really colourful bracket polypore mushroom. I've recently made another video on how to identify it in 7 steps, which I'll link in the video above and below. The mushroom has been used in both Chinese and Japanese medicine for hundreds, if not thousands of years. Some say it goes back to the Han Dynasty in 200 BC. In the 15th century, a tea used to be made, which was said to strengthen bones and tendons. Back then, it was also apparently used for spleen and liver problems. In the 1970s, Japanese researchers discovered that turkey tail mushroom contained polysaccharides, including beta-glucans, which are believed to have had immune-boosting properties. This led to the development of polysaccharide K, or for short, PSK. In Japan, extract from turkey tail mushroom, also known as karawataki, is commonly used alongside chemotherapy. In the 1980s, Chinese researchers isolated another polysaccharide called polysaccharide peptide from turkey tail mushroom, which is also shown to have anti-tumor and immune-enhancing effects. The extract that is known in China is called Yunzi. In the US, researchers have been studying turkey tail mushroom for its potential as a complementary therapy for cancer. One article I read actually said that it was in the 1990s that the National Institutes of Health in the US began funding studies on turkey tail mushroom, which actually led to the development of a clinical trial on its use in breast cancer patients. The well-known mycologist Paul Stamets' mother was actually included in a clinical trial investigating the use for turkey tail mushroom for breast cancer.
Paul Stamets' mother's story is quite an amazing one. In June 2009, she was diagnosed with stage 4 breast cancer and given less than 3 months to live. Her doctor prescribed her with Taxol and Herceptin, but also told her about a trial that was going on with turkey tail mushrooms. She ended up taking 8 capsules of turkey tail a day. 3 years on, she had no detectable tumours. I've linked the TED talk below if you're interested in hearing the full fascinating story.
The research into turkey tail mushrooms is quite global. There are other countries also studying it, such as Korea, Taiwan, and some other countries in Europe too. Some of these studies have focused on the anti-inflammatory and the antioxidant properties of turkey tail mushrooms, and some are also looking into its potential benefits for chronic diseases such as hepatitis C. Overall, research into turkey tail mushrooms is pretty much ongoing, and scientists are looking further into how this wonderful mushroom could potentially help us even further. So that's a little bit of the history of the turkey tail mushroom. Let's look at some of the other benefits that consuming this mushroom could actually have on us. Firstly, they're packed full of antioxidants, including phenols and flavonoids. One study, which I've linked below, actually found 35 different phenolic properties within the turkey tail mushroom extract. These antioxidant compounds promote immune system health by reducing inflammation and releasing protective compounds in our bodies, which can help protect our bodies from free radicals, which are essentially unstable atoms that can damage our cells and cause illness. I already mentioned the polysaccharides that are found in turkey tail mushroom extract. These are actually beta-glucans. These beta-glucans don't actually fight disease themselves. They're actually an immunomodulating agent. They do this by binding to receptors on immune cells such as macrophages and natural killer cells. This binding triggers a signaling pathway that activates these immune cells and stimulates them to produce cytokines. These cytokines in turn stimulate the activation of other immune cells such as T cells and B cells, leading to an overall increase in the immune response. This can actually help our immune systems by helping to stop tumours grow and spreading to other parts of our bodies. There are quite a few studies which have been done with this. If you're interested in looking at how beta-glucans work, I've actually linked a few of the studies below. There are actually another couple of papers which talk about how this could potentially help with COVID-19. Now, no clinical trials have actually conducted on this, as far as I'm aware, but there is a hypothesis out there that these things could actually work with COVID-19. Anti-inflammatory effects. So turkey tail mushrooms have been shown to have anti-inflammatory effects on the body. These are things such as arthritis and inflammatory bowel disease. A study published in the Journal of Ethnopharmacology found that polysaccharide extract from turkey tail mushroom was able to reduce inflammation in mice. One thing that I'm really passionate about is gut health, and how our microbiome can influence our overall health. How the foods we eat influence this is really fascinating to me. Turkey tail mushroom has actually been shown to be a prebiotic, which promote the growth of beneficial bacteria in our gut. Does this because it contains complex carbs, like the polysaccharides I mentioned earlier, which act as a food source for our gut bacteria. Another really exciting potential benefit is how the turkey tail mushroom can actually improve endurance. It's believed that the polysaccharides and other compounds found in turkey tail actually reduces inflammation and improves oxygen utilization. More research is needed to understand how effective this is. With me being a long distance runner, I'm actually really excited to understand how turkey tails could help improve my endurance. There really are a plethora of benefits that are being looked into for this turkey tail mushroom. Others are cardiovascular health, including reducing blood pressure and cholesterol levels, respiratory illnesses such as asthma. It's been used for these purposes for a very long time, but it would be great to see some scientific evidence to support this also. There's also research looking into skin health also, reducing fine lines and things like that. Luckily, I'm not in need of any of that. So that was a fairly long list of benefits, and it's one of the main reasons I personally am so interested in how we can use plants and mushrooms to further our health. The reason I love them so much is that the benefits aren't necessarily targeted, but they give us more of a spectrum of benefits. So how can we use them? Let's go indoors and I'll show you how.
So how can you use the turkey tail mushroom? Turkey tail is actually a really common mushroom, and it's found all over the world, from Asia, Europe, North America. It's typically found on dead wood such as stumps and logs, but it does prefer hardwood to soft. If you're interested in foraging turkey tails for yourself, do check out my 7-step guide on how to identify it successfully. There are many lookalikes out there, so you want to make sure you're getting exactly what you're looking for. If you don't have any turkey tails where you live, or you're not comfortable foraging it, you can find them in health food stores or reputable online retailers. My preferred way of consuming turkey tails is to make a tea. All I do is break up some turkey tails and put it in hot water for about 40 to 45 minutes. You don't want to bring that water to a boil. Bring it to around 75 to 80 degrees. After that 40 to 45 minutes, just strain it and drink. Some of you might be wondering why you just don't go ahead and eat it. Well, these turkey tails aren't the best to actually consume. They're really tough and rubbery when fresh, and when they're dried, they are pretty much rock hard. Another way you could use them is to include them in broths and soups and things like that. Depending on the type of soup you're having, you could either put them in whole and fish them out when you're eating your soup, or what I prefer to do is actually grind it into a powder and put it in that way. It also gives the soup a bit of a mild mushroomy flavor, which I quite like. You can also buy turkey tail supplements in capsules. Although I personally don't buy capsules of turkey tail mushroom, I do actually buy reishi mushroom tablets because I don't have much reishi where I live. I typically use it if myself or one of my family is coming down with a cold or a flu or something like that. What I actually do is make a tea out of birch polypore and turkey tail to give my immune system a real boost. So if you do want to get the benefits of turkey tail mushrooms, it really is as simple as that. If you enjoyed this video and you'd like to learn more about foraging plants and mushrooms and how they can be beneficial to us, please do give the video a like and do subscribe to the channel. Cheers.